We ask you to bless this loving couple and give them the gifts of good health and contentment. We pray that you let them experience the comforts of marriage throughout their life together. Let your holy light shine and be a guide for them as they join their lives as husband and wife. Dearly beloved, we have gathered here today to celebrate love. The love of two people, the love of parent for child, the love of family and friends. Today, you're uniting two families into one bonded by a shared value of love and commitment. Heather and Chris had a much bigger guest list when they started working on their wedding a year ago with me. It was a long and painful process for them to remove people from this list. I do not wish this task on anyone, and I commend them for making it through that process. Planning a wedding is hard enough, and adding a pandemic to it makes it significantly harder. I mention this because it says a lot about this couple and the people in their lives. Dear guest, you are here to represent each of the communities Heather and Chris are part of. You have given them love and encouragement along the way. You are not here just to celebrate. You are here to be a witness to the power of their love. As we all know, marriage is a serious commitment, and life is not a predictable journey. There will be disappointments and challenges along the way. This occurs to all married couples. It is normal. Sometimes these events are small and sometimes incredibly difficult. You are here to serve as very special guardians to their partnership and to become a circle of love and support around their union. This will help them along to have a long and fulfilling marriage. Your role is to offer encouragement and compassion, wisdom and insights, reassurance and comfort, by reminding them of this incredible love that they share. I ask you now all to make a promise to support their marriage. Please respond, "I will," if that is your intention at the end of the question. Will you respect their marriage? Will you foster love within their relationship?
I will.
Will you help them keep their sense of humor about marriage? Usually the people who have been married a long time say that nice and loud. And will you celebrate their love today and all the days into the future?
I will.
Wonderful. That still and settled place, by Edward Monkton. In that still and settled place, there's nobody but you. You're where I breathe my oxygen. You're where I see my view. And when the world feels full of noise, my heart knows what to do. It finds that still and settled place and dances there with you. Heather and Chris, we are here to celebrate your relationship and to unite your lives and the lives of your children in marriage. Today, you're marrying your best friend and the person you're in love with, the person who understands you just by looking in your eyes. You are meant to be together, balancing each other's strengths and weaknesses, acknowledging what makes you different and unique, and knowing that that's what makes you stronger together. Think back to when you really understood what you meant to each other. Remember when you realized how good you were together. The excitement of the potential between you. How you wanted to spend more time just talking and sharing your lives. How you brought out the best in each other and still do. Always carry those sparks of realization in your heart. Keep them burning brightly by being generous and kind to each other. Cherish your spouse by making their happiness your top priority. Give them the best you have to offer. Put them first before anyone or anything. Your vows today are to not let the busyness and distractions of the world make you forget how incredibly lucky you are. Your promise is to take care of each other and show your love daily, even if it is a small gesture. Leave no room for doubt about your love and commitment. Today, your entrance into marriage is saying, I am so lucky that our paths crossed. I love you, I trust you, you're my best friend, and I'm looking forward to sharing our lives together. Your marriage is your home, your sanctuary from the world, a place where you can breathe easy and be yourselves, a safe place to be comforted in your times of struggle and sadness, a space to relax and be vulnerable. Protect this place and treat it with care. Fill your home with laughter and kind words. Make it a place to build on this close and wonderful friendship you share. Welcome in positive ideas and people. Leave the rest outside. And focus on what truly matters to the two of you, like you're doing today. I have another little poem for you guys. I Choose You by Tyler Kent White. I choose you again and again. At the start and the finish of every single day, no matter the season, no matter the year, I choose you to struggle and succeed with, to fight and make up with, to love and grow old with. I choose you knowing there are still trails we must travel, knowing there are mountains left to climb. I choose you to always be by my side. Heather and Chris, it is my duty to ask you if you would like to marry each other. So let me ask you first, Chris. Chris, would you like Heather to be your wife?
Yes.
Okay. And Heather, would you like Chris to be your husband?
Yes.
I'm going to invite you to share your vows with each other. And Chris, I'll have you go first.
No, oh. She wanted to go first.
Okay, I'll have you go first.
I take you, Christopher, as my partner and as my husband. I promise to always find home in you. If you should ever stumble, may you always steady yourself with my hand. I'll never let you fall. You are my best friend, my lover, and my soulmate. I promise to protect you and comfort you. I will never abandon you or neglect you. I promise to be strong and faithful and always will feel safe in your arms. As long as you stay, I will try. And as long as you try, I will stay. I do, and I will always be forever yours till the end. And P.S. I love you.
Well, I don't really talk much, but I wrote a couple things down. Heather, when we started dating, I truly learned a lot. I learned new ways to view things, new ways to do things. I also learned that I didn't know everything. I also learned to laugh is the most important thing. I learned what it was not to be alone. You are my world, truly my other half. I am so grateful for all you bring into my life. Because of you, I strive to be a better man, a better father. I love how much you've embraced my family, and I promise that for the rest of my life, I will dote on you like I do now and forever. I promise to always be here. I won't take you for granted for what we have and who you are. I promise you, you won't be alone. I'll always stand beside you through the good and the bad. I will take everything. I will take a chance on everything because of you. I will always shower you with the love and affection that you always deserve. I promise to strive to keep you safe, happy, and loved. I promise to love and honor you, cherish you for eternity, even the peacock. Thank you for being you and helping me be me. I can't wait to start our adventure together as husband and wife. I love you more than you will ever know, and I promise to spend the rest of my life trying to show you.
Let the power of your words strengthen your relationship, and let your love be your guide. Now I'm going to ask for the rings. And if you could just show these rings to your guests. These rings are not only to serve as reminders to this couple, but they also are reminders to all of you of the very serious responsibility that you've promised to take on, which is to be a circle of love and support around their marriage. And for the two of you, the reason people fall in love with each other is because they admire and respect the other person. And so on your rings, store those ideas, those values that you cherish most deeply about each other. And when you, if you ever, should come across a point where you're particularly frustrated with each other, which is normal for all couples, then look at your rings and remember the beautiful qualities, the wonderful qualities that you cherish so dearly about each other. And instead of turning away, turn toward each other. And for all of you, remember to remind them of how much fun they have together and how they bring out the best in each other like nobody else. So I'll have you go first, Chris, and repeating after me as you place this on Heather's finger. Heather, take this ring.
Heather, take this ring.
As a symbol of my commitment to you.
As a symbol of my commitment to you.
And when you look at this ring.
And when you look at this ring.
Remember this day.
Remember this day.
This moment.
This moment.
And how much I love you.
And how much I love you.
And Heather, it's your turn. Repeat after me. Chris, take this ring.
Chris, take this ring.
As a symbol of my commitment to you.
As a symbol of my commitment to you.
And when you look at this ring.
And when you look at this ring.
Remember this day.
Remember this day.
This moment.
This moment.
And how much I love you.
And how much I love you.
The good people of the state of Vermont elected me a justice of the peace, And by doing so, have given me the authority to marry this couple here in this beautiful state of Vermont. So on this beautiful, at this beautiful home of the couple, with our beloved peacock and little donkey, surrounded by all the people who love you both so dearly, I declare you husband and wife and invite you to begin your marriage with a great kiss.
At last, my love has come along. My lonely days are over. Was wrapped up in clover. The night I looked at you, and I found a dream that I could speak to, a dream that I can call my own. I found a thrill to press my cheek to, a thrill that I have never known. Oh yeah, yeah. You smile.
Always modest. All right. My dad and I have always been super close. Less of a father and son dynamic and more of a best friend. There have been so many times I can remember. Some good, some that could have got us into a lot of trouble, but it's always been an adventure no matter what. We've always had each other's back. He's the first person I think of whenever I need something. And I've always been there for him as well. When I first met Heather, I thought she was really nice, but I didn't really know her yet. So I gave her a chance. The more we started to see each other, she started treating me more like a son and less of a coworker, because that's how the dynamic started at first. I've always gotten along with her, and she's very thoughtful even when she doesn't have to be. I realized that her and my dad would be a good match the more they were around each other. Their chemistry was undeniable. Heather's family had taken me in as one of their own way before this day, and I'm very thankful for that as well. I love you guys, and congratulations. I wish you both an incredible future. Congratulations, Dad. You have found your soulmate. Heather, welcome to the family.
Hello, my name is Cody, and for those of you who don't know me, I'm Heather's younger sister and a proud representative of Joanne's Offspring and Company. I'm here today to pass along a message to a valued customer in regards to a recent purchase. Dear Mr. Christopher Flanagan, you recently finalized your purchase of the 1978 Special Edition Heather Bot on June 20th of 2020. We are so glad that you found satisfaction in our services and honored that we could provide you with a product you'll cherish for a lifetime. For your safety during these trying times, paper directions were not included in the packaging. These measures were taken in order to minimize the spread of germs on our deliveries. We have instead been reaching our customers over the phone and by email. However, our team was unable to reach you remotely, and there are some things you must know concerning your recent purchase of the 1978 Special Edition Heather Bot. As the product you've purchased is a one-of-a-kind masterpiece, it's expected that you handle your product with kid gloves to ensure long-lasting enjoyment and minimize wear and tear over time. As I'm sure you're already aware from the website description of the product, this model of the Heather Bot has some pretty remarkable features. In addition to the most strikingly beautiful light blue eyes you've ever seen, our special edition Heather Bot transcends the effects of aging with the complexion of a baby's butt, a smile that will light up a room, and even interchangeable hair colors. Our special edition Heather Bot stands at a whopping 5 feet nothing, but do not be deceived, for all 90 pounds of her is muscle with a splash of attitude. This bot is known best for her energetic personality, quick-witted sense of humor, and a generous spirit. For the optimum experience, it is important that you follow these instructions to clean and care for your product. Shower her with compliments and affection so she shines and sparkles. Take her shopping on a regular basis. Note, you'll need to stay in shape in order to haul all of her purchases, however obscure they might be, out of the mall and place them gently into her chosen car for the week. Brush and play with her hair before bed. Note, no matter how tired you might be, this is necessary. It's always important that she goes to bed relaxed for both your safety and hers. It's crucial that you feed your Heather Bot at least twice a day with a fat bowl of Honey Smacks or Lucky Charms cereal and fuel her up with a Dunkin' coffee to ease her temper.
And I was thinking you just like my cereal.
And finally, take her to a nail salon every 2 weeks so that her nails stay senselessly long and beautiful. As you are one of our valued customers, we found it important to warn you, though, about a few things. One, you should always keep in mind that a Heather Bot will do what a Heather Bot wants to do. She is programmed that way, and there's just no use fighting it. Had you been in the market for something you could have more control over, I would have recommended one of the bots from our pushover collection. In the making of the 1978 Special Edition Heather Bot, a crucial part was forgotten, a filter. Our newer versions have been checked and double-checked so as not to make that mistake again. The absence of a filter has been known to have you cringing in situations or diving behind the nearest clothes rack. 3, it should also be noted that you might succumb to embarrassment when she cracks a witty one-liner that has you crouched in the middle of the milk aisle trying not to wet your pants. Other than these small malfunctions, your Heather Bot should run about as smoothly as a 6-cylinder hitting on 5. We hope you love our 1978 Special Edition Heather Bot as much as we do. You are a very, very lucky guy to have her, as she is truly one of a kind. All kidding aside, though, our warranty is now void. For real, though, I love you so much, Heather and Chris, and we are so excited to welcome you to our loony family. So cheers to love, laughter, and happily ever.
You're so creative.
See the way you're taking care of your mama, the way you're taking care of me, the way you line up any room, girl, you're what this world should be. Tomorrow, tonight, the rest of my life, I wanna be the man you want me to be. So starting right now, girl, tell me everything you need. I just wanna wake up every day here in this bed, never leave, I love you, left left unsaid. It might take 100 lifetimes to do, but baby, I just wanna be good as you. Girl, you're more than just the surface. Yeah, you got the heart of gold. So when it comes to loving you, baby, now it'll never get old. Tomorrow, tonight, the rest of my life, I wanna be the man you want me to be. So starting right now, girl, tell me everything you need. I just wanna wake up every day here in this bed. Never leave, I love you left unsaid. You.